Hello students, welcome in math class. Students, we have started with the chapter Principle of Mathematical Induction and we have discussed some examples based on this principle and we have discussed three steps of this principle. Today we are going to start with some more important and difficult example based on it. Let's start with its first example. For all n belonging to n, that is for natural numbers, prove that 1 dot 2, here dot means multiplication, plus 2 into 3, plus 3 into 4, plus so on, n into n plus 1 is equal to n into n plus 1 into n plus 2 upon 3. Here, terms are coming in multiplication. But we have to follow the same steps and pattern discussed for the previous example. So, very first thing, consider it as a PN, the whole statement. Next, for step number 1, we have to put n is equal to 1. That is, left hand side will become the first term only. That is, 1 into 2. So, answer is 2. On right hand side, when you put the value, we get 1 into 1 plus 1 into 1 plus 2 like this upon 3. So, 1 into 2 into 3 upon 3. Here 3 will be cut and we are left with 2. So, left hand side and right hand side both are equal to 2. Therefore, result is true for n is equal to 1. Now in step number 2, we have to assume that result is true for n is equal to k. And for writing the result, we have to simply replace n with k. So we got 1 into 2 plus 2 into 3 plus 3 into 4 plus so on. Here k into k plus 1 is equal to k into k plus 1 into k plus 2 upon 3. Now, in step number 3, we have to prove that result is true for n is equal to k plus 1. So first, let's write what we desire in the result. So pk plus 1 terms can be written as first k terms as it is. Next, we have to write down the k plus 1. For writing the k plus 1 term, change n with k plus 1. So we get here k plus 1, k plus 2 is the k plus 1th term. Similarly, on the right hand side, replace n with k plus 1. So, answer must be k plus 1, k plus 2, k plus 3 upon 3. Now, we have to work for this result. Again, we have to start from the left hand side. That is 1 into 2. Plus 2 into 3 plus 3 into k and so on till k terms k into k plus 1 and the last one is a k plus 1 into k plus 2. Now using step number 2, we are having the value for the sum of these terms. So in place of first k terms, put this value, we will get k into k plus 1 into k plus 2 upon 3 and last term as it is. Now as you can see, these two factors are common. So, write these common factors outside the bracket, k plus 1, k plus 2 and the left two terms in the bracket. Now, we are left with k upon 3 plus 1 like this. When you take the LCM, you will get k plus 3 upon 3. So, we get the desired result, that is these three terms in multiplication divide by 3. So, it is a right hand side. Therefore, result is true for n is equal to k plus 1. Therefore, by principle of mathematical induction, this statement PN is true for all natural numbers. Whatever the statement is there, we have to follow the same three steps of the principle. Let's do one more important example. Using principle of mathematical induction, prove that 41 raised to power n minus 14 raised to power n is a multiple of 27 for all n belonging to capital N, that is a for all natural numbers. Here we have to show that number of this form is always a multiple of 27. Now, very first thing, consider it as a Pn. Let Pn is 41 raised to power n minus 14 raised to power n is a multiple of 27. Firstly, we will check for n is equal to 1. Now, here left hand side and right hand side is not there. So, we will simply put the value in the given statement. So, 41 raised to power 1 minus 14 raised to power 1, we are getting 27. Now, 27 is the first multiple of 27. Therefore, result is true for n is equal to 1. Now, in step number 2, we have to assume that result is true for n is equal to k. K is any positive integer. That is, pk 41 raised to power k minus 14 raised to power k is a multiple of 27. It may be first multiple, second multiple, third multiple, or any negative multiple are also there. So, when you solve it, 41 raised to power k minus 14 raised to power k, it must be equal to some multiple. So, I have written 27 into t, where t is some integer. It may be positive, negative, or 0 also. From here, find the value of 14 raised to power k. Just shift 14 raised to power k on the other hand side. So, we are left with 41 raised to power k is equal to 27 t plus 14 raised to power k. Now, in third step, we have to prove that result is true for n is equal to k plus 1. That is, 41 raised to power k plus 1 minus 14 raised to power k plus 1 is a multiple of 27. For k terms, we have assumed that it is true. If we take one more term than the k, then the result is also true for those number of terms. Now again, just in place of n, put the value k plus 1. 41 raised to power k plus 1 minus 14 raised to power k plus 1. Now we know that if we are having a term with the same basis, only then powers are added. So, write it with the basis and separate their parts. So, it can be written as 41 raised to power k into 41 raised to power 1. Similarly, 14 raised to power k into 14. Now, from step number 2, we are having the value of 14 raised to power k. Put this value in place of 41 raised to power k like this. This 41 I have written here. And these terms can be written as 14. I have written 14 raised to power k in the bracket because we can't multiply these terms because here bases are same but their powers are not same. Now next, when you open the bracket by using the arrow method, you will get 41 into 27 t plus 41 into 14 raised to power k. Again, you can't multiply these terms. And last one, as it is. Now, you can see that second and third term having 14 raised to power k in both the terms. So, these are the like terms. When you subtract their coefficients, you will get 41 minus 14. And first term as it is. And after subtracting, we are left with 27 into 14 raised to power k. Now, we are having two terms. In both the terms, 27 is a common number. So, when you take 27 common, you are left with 41 t plus 14 raised to power k. Now, whatever the value of t or k is there, when you put the values, any value of t and k, you will always get some integer. And so, I have written 27 into some integer. We have to show that it is a multiple of 27. So, 27 must be a common factor. So, that we have proved. Therefore, result is true for n is equal to k plus 1 or pk plus 1 is true. Hence, by principle of mathematical induction, statement Pn is true for all natural numbers. Students, now you all are able to solve sums related to these type of principle of mathematical induction. Before starting the worksheet given in the SNAP homework, you must go through the links guided in the SNAP homework. Thank you.